Hi, my name is Adele, and together with my partner Rania, we're working with your teachers in this Out of This World project that you're working on for your Oral Bagrut in the end, for your research project. And before I even start this tutorial, I want to tell you what amazing things we've been hearing from your teachers about the work that you're doing. It's really inspiring to be watching you from afar. So what I'm going to do in today's tutorial is I'm going to teach all of you how to make a website to put your project on in the end. Now you may ask, why do we need a website? I'll tell you. First of all, the website enables you more easily to share your work with your partners who are in other schools and not working with you all the time. Secondly, it enables you to share your work with your teachers and your partner school's teachers. It also lets you share your work with Rania and with myself so that we can see what you're doing as well. But finally, the most important thing is that you will always know where your project is, because this is the project that you're going to be talking about on your Oral Bagrut in grade 12. So you'll never have to worry about the project getting lost or your mother throwing it out or your dog eating it. It will be there safely waiting for you on your Oral Bagrut in the 12th grade. Now the things I'm going to show you are just a suggestion. You all have to build a site, but your team teachers will tell you exactly what they expect to be on your site. So let's go to the computer. I'm going to start off by showing you what the site is going to look like in the end, what we're going to be aiming at, and then we're going to walk through about 10 steps showing you exactly how to do it. So each group is going to have their own website, and there's going to be a home page where it's going to have the topic and the names of your school and the names of the students in your school that are part of your group, the two different schools. Next page is introduction, where you should invite the reader of your project to come in and read about your project, give a little bit of an overview, tell them what it's going to be about and how you did it. The next page is going to be the space exhibition, where you're going to embed the space exhibition activities that you did. Then your research paper will be the next page. After that, you'll have the biography, a possible page for related movies if your teacher wants that. Again, all of the pages here are just a suggestion. Your teachers will tell you exactly which pages to put in for your projects. And finally, the creative section, where you're going to embed whatever creative activity it is that you do. So let's see how we got here. Step one, one of the members of your group will go into their Gmail and open up the website. In order to do it through your Gmail, you click on the 9 dots and you go to Sites. Be sure you go to New Google Sites. And click on the red button with the plus sign to create a new site. There we go. Step number two, name it. So your site should have the name of this project. And for the actual title, not what you're going to see on the front page, but for the title, you should name it with the name of your school and your last names. Step number three, let's make this look pretty. You sit on the header and you can change, first of all, you can change the header type. You can have it either as a large banner. I suggest you do this for the first page because there's not a lot of writing that has to be done here. And pages after that can just be the banner. But again, you get to decide. And let's change the image. You can either upload an image from your computers or your drives, or you can select an image that they have here. So I'm going to go for this for the first page. Step number four, how do we add the text? Well, that's really easy.
You go to where it says text box. There are two different types of text that you can add. You can either have it be normal text, or you can have it be a title, a heading, or subheading. It's all a matter of your preference, aesthetic decision. And you can type as much as you want here, or all justified. Play around with it. Step number five, add a page. As we saw on our site, there are a few pages, and here's how you add them. You go to Pages, and you click down here to add a page. The next page that we want to do after the home page will be Introduction. There we go, Introduction. We can change the banner, the image. We can change the header type. Here it's a banner. We can also have a title only if you want. So the home is this kind. Let's make it a large banner. And the introduction, your navigation will be up top. And that's your introduction, page two. So I'm just going to add a few more pages. So we said there's introduction and there's space exhibition. And research paper. Bibliography. Related movies. As you can see, each time I add it, it gets put up here. Creative section. These are titles, so be sure that each word has a capital letter. And if afterwards you want to change the order, you just go here and drag them. And then they move around up here also in the navigation. In case your teacher wants to have you put in related movies. So you go to the related movies page and you go to insert and you look for the YouTube, grab the URL of the YouTube you want to share, put it in here, click on that, the magnifying glass, and the YouTube itself, select, and there your YouTube is now embedded in this page. Of course, for the section of your research paper, you have your research paper which you are working on a Google Doc. And it's very easy to embed it in here. Anything that is in your drive can be embedded in the Google site. So we're going to go to, we're on the page for the research paper. I'm going to go to my drive. And I'm going to look for my sample research paper. And the research paper is now embedded in the site. Be very sure that the Google Doc itself is shared with everybody so that everybody who goes in can see it. So let's preview it. This is how you see what it's going to look like. Go to where the eye is, that gives you a preview. And this is what you'll see when it's published, homepage, the introduction, space exhibition, research paper, bibliography, and this is what it's going to look like if you see it on the phone or a tablet and on the computer. Next step, we publish it. because nobody can see what it is except for the editors unless it's published. Okay, here we have the web address. You can request that public search engines do not display your site. Your teacher will know if you want to do that or not. I'm going to leave this open so that people can find it and publish. There, published successfully. And it's from this place, from this link, that you're going to share your site with your teacher. You grab this URL and you put it in an email and you send it to your teacher. Then your teacher can access it. You could stick that in a WhatsApp. You can share it any way you can share any other link. Another thing that you're going to want to be sure that you do, we said that in the beginning that one person from each group opens up the site, but once it's open, you want to share it with the other members of your group as editors. So you put their email addresses in here. And you add a message. Everybody in your group has responsibility for your website. That gives them editing rights. But when you're sharing it to somebody to show, you want to go to the View Published Site. And then you click here, as I said before, and you share that with your teachers. So let's look again at what the final site looks like. So again, we have the front page, the landing page, the introduction, which your teachers will teach you how to do and tell you what they want here, space exhibition, if your teachers want it. Again, your teachers will decide exactly what's going to be in your project. This is just a suggestion. Of course, everybody's project is going to have their research paper in it, the blah, blah, blah paper, and a bibliography that shows where, ooh, there's a typo there. Let's fix that. It's always editable. Any related movies you saw that helped you, and your creative section.
Right. So I hope that's clear. If you have any questions, you can talk to your teachers, and if they need help, they always know how to get to me or to Rania, and we can help them. So keep up the great work. We look forward to seeing all of the amazing products that you make and meeting you at the end of the program.
Six,
bye.
Five. 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All engine running. Liftoff. We have a liftoff.